The Colgate Comedy Hour, starring Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis, with their special guest Rosemary Clooney, and Danny Arnold, Sarah Berner, and Harvey Birdbox. Presented by the Colgate Palmolive Company, makers of Halo Shampoo, Colgate Dental Cream, Ajax Cleanser, and Palmolive Soap. And now the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show.
Gentlemen and fellow psychiatrists, it is with a great deal of pleasure that I welcome you to our latest annual psychiatrist conference. This year we're doing things a little differently. For the first time in our history, we shall have some entertainment. I've invited two of the nation's leading personalities, and from what I hear, they should be very interesting indeed. And now it gives me great pleasure to present our guests, the show business phenomenon of our time, Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis. Psychiatrist.
That's the way we always entertain.
No, sir, you'll do much better with this.
What do you want me to do?
Now, no, you just lie right down.
Lay down. Lay down. You want we should entertain like this?
What are you doing, sir?
Do anything you want to do.
All right, start.
Oh, toot, toot. I can't sing playing down here.
That's all right.
Well, just tell a joke. Tell a joke.
Yeah, well, the funny thing happened the other day. Now, I was talking to you. I don't like this idea. I'll bet you right in the head. We come here to stay nice and do our act. I don't have to do it if I don't want to.
No, there, young man. Nothing.
He's not too well.
Well, yes, nothing you say will upset us, because you see, we are psychiatrists. Men who are trained to handle every type of personality. We are well adjusted. It is impossible for you to upset us for that very reason.
What?
Well, we are well adjusted.
They are well adjusted.
They're well adjusted.
Every time we go somewhere, why do you have to act like this, Jerry?
I didn't do nothing.
I didn't do anything.
Then neither one of us is to blame.
Don't you realize what's happening?
No.
We have a position which we must uphold.
Well, what do you mean we have a position we must uphold?
I was reading in the paper the other day, it says, Bing Crosby, you and myself, you know, we pay so much tax to the government. All the money we pay enough to pay the vice president, the president, and the Senate, all their salaries.
We pay all those guys their salary?
Right.
You fellas in the Senate, be over the house tomorrow and wash the car.
All right. Can you see 800 guys washing my little car?
I'll be all right. What happened to the crowd?
Now, give me the introduction of my song.
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. I ain't got no introduction.
You have no introduction. We have no introduction. They have no introduction.
Who the heck's got all the introductions?
Just introduce my song.
All right, don't yell. I'm sensitive, and you should know it after all these years. To yell, the whole head
all right.
squeezes.
All right.
All right, I'll introduce you.
Well, here we are again. Happy to come into your living rooms and present another show.
I'd like to say, oh, no, where's the other one? Before we start, I would like to make mention of the fact, oh, ha, 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 he's holding up the cards with the words I shouldn't forget. That's dirty what you got on. I would like to say that watching right here, we might as well do all the plugs. My father, Danny Lewis, is currently at the Paramount Theater in New York. And we'd like you to go see him. He's on the show with Big Jim McLean. Dean's in mind, the latest picture. And we want you to watch for Dad's, for Dean's dad. He's opening in Italy at the Lowy's Italy on Tuesday. Oh, good heavens, I almost lost that one, but I came right back punching, didn't I?
Nationwide chain, Bob Stanton reporting. From chain stores, from small country general stores, drug stores, neighborhood dealers, huge supermarkets all over America, comes news that nature's chlorophyll in every cake of palm olive soap is changing America's buying habits. Nature's chlorophyll is what makes palm olive green.
No therapeutic claim is made for the chlorophyll, but you should know this about palm olive. Doctors have proved that Palm Olive's beauty plan brings most women lovelier complexions in 14 days. Gently massage Palm Olive Soap's extra mild, pure lather onto your skin for just a minute, three times a day. Rinse and pat dry. Remember, doctors have proved Palm Olive's beauty results. In fact, Palm Olive's beauty plan is far better for your skin than just average care with any leading toilet soap. Yes, Palm Olive brings out beauty while it cleans your skin.
Today, buy the regular or bath-sized palm olive, the chlorophyll green soap with the pure white lather. Same wrapper, same low price. Yes, nature's chlorophyll is in every cake of palm olive soap. Nature's chlorophyll is what makes palm olive green.
Ladies and gentlemen, many of our viewers have been curious to know how Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis spent their summer vacation. Well, the boys did many things, but the most interesting thing of all was their trip abroad. The wonderful 2 weeks they spent in Italy. This is a little farmhouse, the ancestral home of Dean Martin, where he took Jerry for their vacation in Italy.
But why you bring that what you call that jerky Lewis, huh?
Oh, he's all right. He's just trying to be one of the family. He means well.
That's so. Look, I've been Italian all of my life, and I'm never see anybody act like that.
Well, he'll be okay. He'll be all right. Sure. He's a nice father. Hey! What are you doing?
Hey! Well, what are you doing? Hey!
What?
I don't know.
Come down.
I was just acting like the rest of the family, that's
yeah,
all.
Yeah, the rest of the family. My family's getting a little... They're wondering about you.
Why? I wasn't doing nothing wrong. I like to be part of the family.
Well, look, no, to be part of this family, you know, the Italians, you got to know their language, their ways. You got to know their foods.
Oh, I know all about that food, Dean. I know that. When I was at your house last time, didn't your mother serve us that antipasti?
It's not antipasti. It's antipasto.
Antipasti.
No, antipasto.
Huh? Antibasto.
That's it.
But first we had antipasti. And then after that, didn't she give us lasagna?
Lasagna?
Did you taste it? It was lasagna. Then after that, the main course was Rivoli.
Rivoli? That's a theater.
No wonder I couldn't digest it. What with the usher and the balcony and the marquee was the toughest part of all. That wasn't cooked at all. I swallowed all those things. I'll be all right.
Sure you
will. I want to help your family out. I want to show them that I ain't jerky like that other girl said. Maybe I'll help them out. I'll free some of the grapes for them and save them all their work.
Hey! I don't want you stepping on my grapes. That's for my job, pressing on the grapes.
I see your job of pressing on the grapes. All right. Have this press. Roll sleeves and lapels. Watch the crease in the pants. You keep leaving those fits in the cuffs. I keep telling her about it.
Who can't go on my job when it's
that fox, of course. You know, I don't watch it
anymore. Hey, my shoes. Hey. Hey. Oh, what a fool. Hey, you. You're my fool.
I get the next one. What's going to do?
I'm my shoes. Hey. Go, Mr. Bob.
Benny, Benny. Goodman, Goodman.
Wait. My shoes. My shoes. China, my shoes.
He's a driving me crazy. Nice.
What? Get out of here. You're drunk anyhow. What is he yelling at me for?
Well, you shouldn't do a thing like go on and apologize to him.
I will not.
I said apologize. Put your shoes on and go apologize.
Well, all right, but gee whiz, I don't... Oh!
All right, stop faking. Just
no, I'm not apologize. Faking. There's something in the shoe, Dean.
Take it out and let's go apologize.
There's something in the shoe. I can't get it out. Wait, Dean. Oh, sure, see?
Oh, yeah, it's a little nail.
You can get Potomaine from that. Oh, no wonder. I knew I was uncomfortable this morning. That is awful. Yes, there are a couple. Look at this. No, under my heel, that was resting.
That's a shame.
Yes, that is awful. Oh, for heaven's sake. Would you believe that?
Never in a million
years.
Oh,
this one will really knock you down. Look at that. Oh, that is. Oh, look at that. Oh, no wonder I had such trouble. Here, yes. Lift it under the shoe, buddy. Hurt more than any of them.
You should have said
you
that.
Got any more down there? Oh, he's got more, yeah. Oh, this is painful, right under the heel.
Yeah, no oh, reason that for this
a...
one.
Oh, this is ridiculous.
I don't even want to look at this one.
These riders are upset.
Sure. Wait, see this.
How could this be in a shoe? Isn't that ridiculous? Oh, sure. Look at this.
I've got such cuts in my foot from these things and that shoe. I walked almost 15 seconds in this sketch with all this stuff. Would you believe that?
Oh, Douglas Fairbanks is coming out.
Well, now, don't
stuff.
You feel silly.
Ah, oh, Ma!
What are you...
Ma!
Oh, it's a phone. Yellow. Jerry, it's your mother from New Jersey, Newark.
She heard me all the way yelling?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so excited. Hello, Ma, is that you?
Hey, wait a minute. Why are you in such a big hurry? Stop for you hollering.
That's not my mother.
Operator, you got to talk real easy, gently, nicely, softly. Use gestures. Gestures takes the place of many words in Italy, you fool.
When I talk.
Sure, look, right.
Yes,
easy.
Yes.
Easy.
Hey, operator, I want to talk to my mama.
Hey, why you're not saying.
Oh, let's get out. I don't.
Get out of here.
I want to talk to my mother.
She'll call you later. She'll call you later. How about having something to eat?
Yes, I'm hungry. I really am. Oh, I am so hungry. I'm so glad you brought that up. I'm hungry.
How about a little pizza?
No, I want to eat something. Well, my dear, why don't I go get that Italian sandwich I made? There's terrific food in there. I'll go get that, all right? I'll go
oh,
get that.
Oh, all right. Go ahead. Go get that. My gosh,
Andy. Dino! Dino!
Hey,
Salvatore!
How do you say?
Molto bene.
That's nice.
And tutta la famiglia.
Bene, bene.
It's good, good.
My friend Jerry and me are going to eat something. You want to join us?
Eat something? Of course I want to eat something.
Hey, I got my sandwich. You want to eat something?
Well, we can't. We have two more people here. I invited Uncle Sal.
Oh, well, we got enough for him.
We're all Italy.
Well, come on, let's eat a little
all
bit.
Right.
This is terrific. Mm-hmm. Oh, we got peppers, and we got pastrami. Oh, terrific stuff. something in there.
I got anchovies down
here. You want to try some of these peppers?
Yeah.
Oh, boy, let's try it out.
Well, that's real good.
That's delicious. I love all this food.
I do, too.
Isn't he going
to why don't you join us, Uncle?
Well, sure.
Go ahead, Sal. How is the meatball?
It's pretty good.
Huh? The sauce is down here. Be my guest.
Say, by the way,
I'm Salvatore. He's a cousin.
Ah, Bonnie, Benny, Benny. Goodman, Goodman.
I'm Dean. I'm his aunt.
Nice to know you, Charlie.
And you?
I'm not in the family at all. Oh, that's terrific. Boy, I love this food. A sound of food. Boy, I hope nobody comes again. What happened to the family? Oh, there it is. Oh, Glenn.
Boy, when you're hungry, boy. That's what I always say. What?
Oh, boy, that is terrific.
All right, look like a...
Hey, Salvador, how about a little vino?
A little vino. Yeah,
Some of that, Dean, huh?
Ah, you're too young to dance.
Hey, Dino! Give him a Samovino!
All right, you're on your own.
Thanks a lot, Dean.
I'm good. Doesn't seem to bother you.
Now, that's terrific, boy.
Sure, that's a good
boy.
Just working up to it.
That's terrific.
Didn't bother you, huh? You'll be all right.
I'm all right, boy. You got a terrific family, Dean.
Oh, they're all around.
Oh, they're wonderful, boy. I'm going to help them out.
Yeah?
Terrific people.
Open them out. What are you going to do?
I'm going to press their prunes.
Great!
They're great. I'm going to help them out. First, I'm going to
press... Easy.
Help them out there. I'll make a little wine for them, Dave.
Easy.
Why, that's terrific.
Easy.
Oh, Jerry.
Maybe this is your town, your street, your house. If it is, your family probably uses Colgate Dental Cream. For more people use Colgate Dental Cream than any other toothpaste in America.
You stop unpleasing breath.
Stop tooth decay best.
Our dentist recommended Colgate Dental Cream because...
Scientific tests have proved that in 7 out of 10 cases... Colgate instantly stops unpleasing breath that originates in the mouth. No other toothpaste has proved so completely it stops unpleasing breath. Brushing teeth right after eating with Colgate Dental Cream makes your mouth feel cleaner longer. Gives you a clean, fresh mouth all day long.
And what's the best protection I can give my children against tooth decay?
The Colgate way stops tooth decay best. It's the most thoroughly proved and accepted home method of oral hygiene known today. And pure, white, safe Colgate will not stain or discolor.
So it's no wonder we always brush our teeth right after eating with Colgate Dental Cream to stop unpleasing breath.
Stop tooth decay best.
Brush your teeth with Colgate. Colgate Dental Cream. It cleans your breath.
What a toothpaste.
What a cleans your teeth.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to have you meet the internationally famous glamour photographer, Mr. Thomas Kelly. Mr. Kelly, would you tell us just how you get glamour into a picture?
Well, the fact of the matter is, the glamour is generally already there.
Well, you mean that most girls are just naturally glamorous?
Certainly, most of them have a number of attractive features. It's just that some of them aren't always at their best. Take hair, for instance. If it's dull and lifeless, there's nothing a camera can do to glorify it. Yours is lovely.
Naturally, I use Halo shampoo.
No wonder. Halo isn't a soap and just can't leave a dulling soap film. I always find it leaves the model's hair glorious and shining with natural highlights.
And Halo is so wonderfully mild and gentle. Doesn't dry or irritate. And no special rinse is needed.
Here's another thing that makes a lot of difference with me. Halo leaves hair manageable. And I find that I can get the special effects that I want without calling in a hairdresser every few minutes.
I agree. Halo always leaves my hair so easy to manage. And how important that is, too, just before a big date. And I love the wonderful clean fragrance of Halo, too.
Well, that about sums it up. Soaping dulls hair, Halo glorifies it the very first time you use it. So why don't you try Halo shampoo?
For heaven's sake, why don't you stop pacing up and down? After all, this is your wedding, not your funeral.
What's the difference?
Oh, stop that foolishness. Here, have a cold drink.
I won't drink unless it's lemonade.
Oh, you'll feel better.
Mother, now look, with all the guests you have coming here, don't you think that you should guard these valuable things?
Oh, don't you worry. Mother has thought of everything.
What did you thought of?
I called a detective agency, and they're sending one of their best men to cover the gifts.
They are? Yes. Detective agents? Well, don't you think that's sort of insulting the guest?
Why, don't be silly. If nobody will ever know that he's a detective, he'll just be another guest. Absolutely inconspicuous.
How about that? In 1 hour, this is going to be my mother-in-law.
In 2 hours, you'll be sorry I didn't take her in.
Get the number of that truck. See ya. Let's in.
Look, come here. You a detective? Yes, I am, sir. Yes, I was sent here, sir. What's your name?
Sherlock.
Sherlock Holmes?
No, Sherlock Fink.
Listen, Fink.
Who's he calling a Fink?
Look. Now, we don't want the guests to know that you're a detective, see?
Yes, sir, I understand, sir.
And we want you to be inconspicuous.
Yes.
We want you to be... Let me rest a while. Inconspicuous. So you take off that coat and... Take off that coat.
I only just met you, sir.
Take off so people won't know you're a detective.
All right, sir. They will never know, sir. They'll never know I'm a detective.
Now, look.
Now, no one will be the wiser.
Yeah.
Isn't that funny?
Is that spelled correctly?
Police athletically, yeah.
All right, that must be the joke. All right, look. You put that coat on.
Are you happy because the joke wasn't funny? What do you think? We got to come up with them all the time? Ain't we entitled a louse one up here and there? I'll smack them all in the mouth.
Okay, now look.
They got him for nothing.
All right. Now, put that coat back on.
It's on.
All right. Well, that was nice. Come with me, Fink.
calling a fink. Now look, here's what I want. Here's what I want you to do.
Yes.
You gotta guard these with your life, Dopey. If you ever guarded anything, guard them right now.
Oh, yes, I will, sir. I promise. On behalf of the Beaver Patrol, 303 Newark, New Jersey.
Oh, Beaver Patrol, Superman, Ohio, 706. Wild pit.
Wee.
Excuse me, dear.
Is she with us?
This is going to be my mother-in-law in 1 hour.
Oh, gee.
What is it, Mother?
Well, it's awfully warm in the house. Can something be done about it before the guests arrive?
Well, I don't know.
How about you, Fink?
Who's she calling a fan? You know, if one of the people that were here gave us a fan, we could...
Oh, I have a splendid idea, sir.
You do?
I have a fan. I carry it with me all the time,
well,
sir.
Well, let's have it.
No, it's in my coat, sir. Every time I work in a place that's stuffy, you know, I always carry a fan. Isn't that convenient? Ha, ha, ha. Those writers really put it in place, huh? Yes. I'll go get the fan. Meanwhile, watch the store.
All right.
I'll
get that fan. Yes, sir. What is this, a puzzle?
Oh, yes. There it is. It's coming out now. Right away. Yeah, the camera on? Yeah.
Oh!
Isn't that a stunning model? Here's my fan, sir. And when I plug that fan in, it will make everything real cool.
Oh, crazy, Daddy.
I'll plug it in and you'll see.
Oh, this thing couldn't... Well, a cup of coffee couldn't be refreshed by this.
That's the switch. Okay. You watch this, sir. I'll plug it in and I'll paint the door to you. It's really terrific.
It's too late to get another burger. You watch this, and boy, I'll be back.
I deserve being reprimanded for what I did.
Oh, Sherlock Fink. Shame on you. 30 lashes. Smack the head, bend the ears, break the chest. Turn the arm, twist it to teach a lesson.
All right, with the arm.
All right. Okay, not in front of the camera. Here, turn it. Okay. I'll guard everything. A knock at the door. Who could that be? Rocky and his mom? Come in. Aha! Just as I thought. Rocky. Angie, eh? Oh, boy.
Trick or treat.
Anybody around?
Not a soul. Just me, sir. Not a soul.
Oh,
are you one of the relative's friends, the bride of the Graham?
I'm a friend of the bride.
You're a friend of the bride?
Yeah, Aunt Elsie's boy.
Aren't you a little early?
Yeah, well, I wanted to surprise them. They think I'm away at boarding school.
How do you like that for the way of thinking? What are you doing, sir? What are you doing?
Oh, these are the presents that I sent. I got to take them back. I got the wrong size.
Oh, that is a shame. Oh, heavens to Betsy. Well, what do you say I help you out, sir?
Oh, all right, but don't break it.
No, I won't. I'll help you out, and you can get all this stuff and return it.
Hey, Finn. Who's he calling a thing?
Who was that?
Oh, that's the bridegroom. The bridegroom.
How do you know he ain't a burglar?
Well, he... This guy thought you were a burglar.
How about that?
How do you like those apples?
Me a burglar?
Yeah.
How could I possibly be a burglar?
Me a burglar?
I thought you were a burglar.
Yeah.
about the gun?
Yeah,
later. We don't want to use it now. Huh? Those old women wear caps, and you ain't got a cap.
I'm not crowding you guys, no. Am I?
Sweaters and they carry guns.
I'm the bride. I'm
you're
the bride.
Not a burglar.
All right, up you go.
You should have seen them. They were 8 feet four. They had fangs and they were clawing at my body, tearing the skin off, bone by bone, crushing them.
How many?
There was about 33.
33.
Exactly. They were breaking the bones, and the back of the head has a hole about this big. I can feel the breeze. I'm all right.
Yeah. Look, it's too late.
Excuse me, sir, but the wedding is about to commence.
That's down on your line. Say it again.
I said, excuse me, sir, but the wedding is about to commence, and I think they'll be needing you.
Now?
Yes, sir.
How about that?
All right. Then, well, listen, now, I gotta go to the wedding.
Oh, I only knew the line. What is it? Clear up.
Oh, yeah. That's right. You clean up here.
Where is the line?
After the burglar bit, Kramer. Oh, I will, sir. I'll clean up everything.
And after you're through, you go.
He's overacting again. All right. I'll go as soon as I clean up. I certainly deserve that.
Shame on you. Did I do that bit?
All righty. I'll clean up everything. I told them we shouldn't open the season. All right. I'll get everything cleaned up. And not only will I clean up in here, but I'll clean up in there. Now, I wonder where I could find a vacuum cleaner.
Well, for goodness sake, if this vacuum cleaner isn't made by the same company that made my little fan.
The foaming cleanser clean pots and pans just like a whiz. Use the paying the elbow tax when you start cleaning with Ajax.
Ajax has foaming action and cuts grease faster and easier than any other leading cleanser.
So use Ajax, the foaming cleanser. Blows the dirt right down the drain.
Ajax polishes as it cleans
and leaves no gritty cleanser scum.
So use Ajax.
Remember, Colgate's Ajax foams as it cleans.
Ajax cuts grease faster than any other leading cleanser.
Ajax polishes as it cleans. Mmm, and it smells good, too.
So use Ajax.
Yes, try Ajax. Because Ajax cleans your pots and pans up to twice as easy and twice as fast as any other leading cleanser. Has a pleasant fragrance and is kind to your hands. Get two cans for kitchen and bathroom. Ajax, the foaming action cleanser.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. We would like, Dean and I have more or less a problem. Well, it's not really a problem, you see, but we watch everybody on television, and
Well, all the people that have shows, they always bring their kids on the show, you know? And the little kid, the daughter, the son. But Dan and I, we got kids. Home they belong. Home, you leave the children, right? A nephew I got, though. And he's very funny, and he's a wonderful, talented kid. And I promised I would put him on the show, and I asked Dean, and he said, So, I would like you to bring him out, make him feel at home, because he's a really a tremendous talent. Little Arnold Rowie said, Look, we're on television. Now say hello to everyone. Arnold. Say hello to everyone, Arnold. Hello. Two syllables. Hello. Oh, hello. Hello. Good. That was splendid. That was fine. Arnold, what would you like to do first, Arnold? Sing the number. Splendid. Splendid, Arnold. Oh, what a kid. You want to sing? What number would you like to do?
It's a strange tune for a child to want to sing.
What key do you do it in, Arnold?
It's pretty high, isn't it?
Well, let's try it. All right?
Begin the beginning. Ready? Dum, dum, learn it. Let them begin the beginning. Ooh, ooh. They never do say away from my heart, yeah. Let them begin, the beginning.
Wonderful. Wonderful, Arnold. What? No, no. Let him get through with everything. Wonderful. What do you want to do? He's going to be another Bobby Breen. Did you hear that, boy? What do you want to do now, Arnold? Dance. Blended. Blended. Arnold. He's gonna dance. You should see him at home on the rug, in his bare feet. You should hear the tap. Okay, here we go. Do 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 Bodeo don't, and no one else say what I won't say, but no one else will ever say. Arnold, Arnold, what happened to the kid? Arnold, where's the kid? Arnold.
Right now, I like two little numbers that I had the good fortune doing while.
Pops, you gotta get with it, Daddy.
I'm not your father. What do you mean, Daddy O' Pops? I'm Dean.
What I'm trying to tell you, Daddy, is that you gotta get on it, see? That's important. Get on it. Get on it. Get on it.
Bring it out here, man. I'll get on it.
Here to be. That's the Plymouth Rock beat.
Oh. Right here. There we go.
Now you got it. Now dig what I'm doing, Jack. Ooh, ooh, ah-ba-doo-oo. Da-ba-doo-ba-da, ah-ba-da, ah-ba-da-ba-da. Ooh, ooh, doo. Go, man. No. Jack.
Oh, Jack.
Skeety-wadi-weedy. Scooty Woody, Nagasaki Broody, a Lookity Pooty, Scatterwacka Needy, a Rookie Tookie. Hold it up, Jack. Hold it up. What I mean to say, man, is you gotta have a beat, little rhythm. Do you play a horn, man?
Sure, I play a horn.
Crazy. Get your horn and let's see you blow a little, man. Go. Go all the way, Jack. That's the way. We gotta get right in there, Dad. Okay, yeah. Play it to him, man. Let's see what you lay down there.
All right, how about Tippy Tippy Tip?
You know, doing the raccoon?
No, I could do, How Deep Is the Ocean?
Splendid, splendid. Oh, great white father. All right, go ahead.
No, I couldn't possibly do it. I must have a background.
An introduction?
If you don't mind.
Splendid.
All right. Oh, please forgive me. Oh.
Here we go. You'll have to get out. Get out. Hurry. Oh, pick up the pieces and come back. Watch me at all times.
I'll play my solo.
Yeah, you play your solo. You play your trumpet solo.
I'm going to play my solo.
All right. Why you work so hard? We've got a few more shows to do.
I'll give you an introduction like you've never seen the likes of, you old hound dog. You ready?
Yes.
All right, boy. Enter.
Why so loud?
All right, you play. Go ahead.
I got carried away.
Yeah.
They were playing our tunes.
Thank you.
Yes, yes, yes.
Whew. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to say...
We'd like to thank you very much for sitting around and listening to all this wonderful material.
You've been wonderful, and we love you all. We'd like to remind you that Tuesday nights we're on the radio for Chesterfield. A, always milder. B, better tasting. C, cash.
Say for you people down in Dallas, Texas, we'll be there at the fair starting October 4th down through the 19th.
And we'd like for you to know that next week is Mr. Eddie Cantor, and please don't forget your contributions to MDA, Muscular Dystrophy Association, New York 8, New York, to help a very, very wonderful charity. We thank you for being so wonderful. Good night, and God bless you.
God bless y'all.
The Colgate Comedy Hour has been presented by Halo Shampoo. Colgate Dental Cream. Ajax Cleanser. And Palmolive Soap. Tonight's cast were Harry Lang, Elsie Baker, Joseph Waring, George Milan, and Byron Kane. Be sure and tune in again next week at the same time when the Colgate Comedy Hour will star Eddie Cantor with his special guests Dorothy L'Amour, Eddie Fisher, and the Will Maston Trio featuring Sammy Davis, Jr. 2 weeks from tonight, Donald O'Connor will be with you with his special guests Broderick Crawford, Ben Blue, and Lisa Kirk. 3 weeks from tonight, the Colgate Comedy Hour will present Bob Hope with his special guest, Fred McMurray. And 4 weeks from tonight, Abbott and Costello will be your stars with their guest, Lisbeth Scott. This is Hal Sawyer saying goodnight for the Colgate Comedy Hour, presented by the Colgate Palmolive Feed Company, makers of quality products since 1806.